The 2021 MLB Home Run Derby field has been officially announced. We know 1 through 8 what the seeds are, who the matchups are going to be, and you can actually fill out the bracket challenge on MLB.com for a chance to win $100,000. So in today's video, I'm going to go through every single player, give you their numbers, give you a little background info on them, and then show you my predictions as to who I think is going to win the MLB Home Run Derby. I'm decent at it. I got Harper right a few years ago. I got Christian Yelich in the year after that, so that wasn't great when my boy Pete Alonso won, but this year, I think I got it on lock. I'm going to tell you who exactly is going to win the 2021 MLB Home Run Derby. So as always, if you guys do enjoy the video, drop a like on it. It does help support the channel, as well as subscribe if you have not yet done so. We are 1,000 subs away from 200K subs. We are so close. Hit that sub button if you haven't done it. Get in the comment section down below. Let me know who you think is going to win the MLB Home Run Derby this year. Drop me a follow on all my social media, Giraffe Neck Mark, links in description. And I want to give a quick shout out to today's sponsor, Auction of Champions. You know them well on this channel. We're giving away a Tatis jersey. Auction of Champions is the best place online to get your sports memorabilia to add to your collection. The number one auction house, you gotta use it. It's simple, you go onto their website. If you don't have an account, you click register, you fill out all your information, you let them know that Giraffe Neck Mark sent you, and you can start bidding on whatever you want from this website. And they've got some great stuff, along with the giveaway information that's coming shortly. Let's take a look at their July 14th All-Star Auction. They've got a signed Derek Jeter on-field jersey, that's sick. Luka Doncic basketball, Ken Griffey card. I mean, they do cards now too that you can bid on. Got a couple of them myself that they sent me, a Bo Bichette Bowman First and a Wander Franco autograph PSA 10. Card. You can get stuff like that on Auction of Champions. And they've also partnered up with me to do a giveaway of a signed Fernando Tatis jersey. Yep, you're going to want to be a part of this one. I put a link in the description to the giveaway, but you fill out your name, you put your email, and in a week from now, in my video on the next Thursday, you will find out who won. Auction of Champions will get in contact with you to win this sick Fernando Tatis Jr. jersey. That's signed, by the way. Click the link in the description to go to auctionofchampions.com and start bidding on sports memorabilia to add to your collection today. So the MLB Home Run Derby is taking place Monday at 8 p.m. Eastern in Colorado. And we're expecting to see a lot of home runs. Now, Colorado is the biggest outfield in Major League Baseball, but also has the highest elevation. So I don't think you should be expecting necessarily more home runs or a crazy amount of them, but we might see some really far hit balls because, as we know, the Mile High City, balls be flying. So let's go. So I'm going to go ahead and tell you who the seeds are 1 through 8, give you a little background on them, and tell you if they're going to win it or not. So, of course, at the number one seed, we have Shohei Ohtani, who's just unbelievable. I mean, everything this guy's doing is just, it's crazy. Shohei Ohtani on the season, 81 games, has a Major League best 32 homers, 18 doubles, 4 triples, 69 RBIs. He's even stole 12 bases, 279 average, 364 on base, 700 slugging, the best in Major League Baseball, and a 1064 OPS. His average exit velo on batted ball events is 93.5, which is the highest among all contestants of the Home Run Derby, and he has an average home run distance of 415. I mean, we've seen this guy hit some crazy shots this year. He's got some of the best raw power in the game. Of course, he's the number one seed, so he's the favorite, but with good reason. Ohtani is a serious threat to win the Home Run Derby. The number two seed coming to us from the Texas Rangers, we've got one of the biggest home run hitters in the entire league, Joey Gallo. Guy's got serious pop. On the year, Gallo has 23 homers in 82 games. His big thing, he's a 3-2 outcome guy, home run, walk, or strikeout. So in a home run derby, of course, you want a guy who literally hits home runs for a third of the hits on the season. 239 average, 395 on base, 515 slugging for a 909 OPS. He's having a fantastic year. And in terms of batted ball events, 92.4 miles per hour and 416 on the average home run distance. Joey Gallo hits balls far. He hits them high. He hits some absolute tanks. In Coors, I don't know how well it's going to play. You don't necessarily want to be a guy that hits these long towering homers. You want some line drives out there, but he's got the endurance. He's strong. He hits the ball hard. He has everything to make up for a home run derby favorite. The number three seed in the home run derby, Matt Olson of the Oakland A's, who's just having a phenomenal season and is a beast. Someone you shouldn't sleep on. I like Matt Olson a lot. Olson on the season in 82 games has 21 homers, 18 doubles, 56 RBIs, hitting 284, the 375 on base, 557 slugging, and a 932 OPS. This is all while playing in Oakland. His home run numbers would be higher if he got out of that absolutely massive stadium and even got out of the AL West. Matt Olson's a sneaky guy to win the home run derby here. Olson has an average exit velo on batted balls at 91.7 miles per hour, one of the lower of the competition, and an average home run distance of 406, so none of those numbers jump off the page, but clearly hitting 21 home runs while playing in Oakland is quite the accomplishment, and now you're hitting it in the Mile High City, Olson could do some damage. The number four seed, shockingly, is going to be a catcher from the Kansas City Royals, Salvador Perez, who, just like Matt Olson, plays in a stadium that is really, really hard to hit a home run in. The outfield is massive in Kansas City. On the season, 86 games played for Salvador Perez, 20 homers, 16 doubles, 51 RBIs, hitting 281 with a 307 on base, 506 slugging, 813 OPS, one of the better hitting catchers in the league. And in terms of batted ball events, he has the second highest average exit velo at 93 miles an hour, but the lowest average home run distance at 399. Salvador Perez feels like he could could be a sneaky pick, but honestly, I don't know. I get worried with catchers. He's obviously strong. He hits the ball super hard, but that average home run distance scares me a little bit. This makes me think that he's more of a line drive guy, maybe hitting the ball on the ground a little bit more often than some of these guys. I don't know. There's things that play well for Salvador Perez and there are things that don't work. In any scenario though, this guy has a shot just like everybody else, and I wouldn't count him out. The number 5 seed, the reigning champion, Pete Alonso of the New York Mets. Pete's not been hitting a lot of home runs this year. He got hot recently. The big thing is he can't hit him at home, so this is great for him because we're playing in Coors where he won't have a problem hitting any home runs. And of course, defending champion. Pete Alonso on the season in 73 games has 15 home runs, 11 doubles, and 45 RBIs, hitting 257 with a 338 on base, 475 slugging, 813 OPS. Pretty solid season. In terms of exit velo on batted ball events, 92.9 miles an hour, just shy of Salvador Perez's 93, and 411 feet for average home run distance. I think Pete has won the home run derby before. We saw that he can pull him. He can go opposite field. He can go center field. He will hit home runs to all parts of the park in the event, and that can play to your advantage sometimes. He can take balls that might be, you know, spit on, or you take them and hit him for home runs to right. He's won it before. He can definitely do it again. Trey Mancini of the Baltimore Orioles comes in at the number 6 seed, and I think this is everybody's like feel good pick. We want Trey Mancini to win it. Came back from cancer, having a great year, had an argument for maybe being an all-star, but he's in the home run derby. Let's see if he's got a shot to win it. On the season, Trey Mancini in 83 games has 15 homers, 17 doubles, a 255 average, 332 on base, 452 slugging, and 785 OPS. So some of the lower numbers slash line wise. And unfortunately for Trey, he also has the lowest average exit velo on batted ball events at 88.5 miles per hour and average home run distance at 407, which is one of the lower ones as well. Trey Mancini is the feel good story. Gets a little bit of help playing in Baltimore, of course, but I think to count this guy out would be ridiculous. He beat cancer. He can win the home run derby. The 7 seed, they always like to get a hometown guy in there. And while Trevor Story is not having an all-star type season, he will be participating in the home run derby. And if anybody knows this park, it's going to be Trevor. Story on the year, a little down, like I said, 74 games, 11 homers, 16 doubles, 41 RBIs, and even stole 16 bases because he's a freak. 252 average, 324 on base, 445 slugging, gives him an OPS of 769, about the lowest of his career. Average exit velo on batted balls of 90.5 miles an hour, and average home run distance at 419, which is the most in the competition. So it is worth noting that Trevor Story hits some bombs. He doesn't have a problem hitting home runs. He's just not having necessarily the best year. He lost Nolan Arenado in this lineup. He's got no protection. It's understandable. Trevor Story, having played in Colorado, he's adjusted to the altitude. That's huge. Trevor Story is always there. These guys getting there, you get tired in Coors. Trevor Story has a shot to really surprise some people. If it wasn't for facing Joey Gallo in the first round, I think he could be a lock to win. We'll see how it goes. And then in eighth, the 8 seed, surprise pick here, but I'm excited to see this guy hit in Coors, Juan Soto of the Washington Nationals. Juan Soto, one of the most talented young players in the game. Honestly, just one of the most talented players in the game. Doesn't even matter with his age. He's a beast, and you got to keep an eye out for him. 75 games, 11 homers, 9 doubles, 42 RBIs, hitting 282 with a 401 on base, 452 slugging, 853 OPS. Average exit velo on batted balls, 92.4 miles an hour, and he has the second lowest average home run distance at 402 feet. Juan Soto as an 8 seed is dangerous. I think his numbers are misleading. This is a dude who's one of the best hitters in the league. He has the ability to hit it to all fields for power. He's a line drive hitter, so the ball isn't going to have a lot of hang time. I think as long as Juan Soto like stays within himself and maybe doesn't swing as physically hard as he can on like the first 10 pitches, this guy's really good, but he's going up against Shohei Ohtani. It's going to be tough. So now that leads us to the portion of the video where we're going to go through the matchups and tell you who's going to win. So of course you got Ohtani going up against Juan Soto first. And to me, in my eyes, as much as I'd like to see Juan Soto win, I can't pick against Shohei Ohtani. I've got him moving on to the next round. He's the best home run hitter in baseball right now. This guy, how could you pick against Shohei? He might be the best player in baseball right now. Like, I'm not doing it. He's moving on to the next round. Next, you got the 2 vs 7 seed matchup, Joey Gallo, 2 seed, going up against Trevor Story. I like a good upset here. And if it wasn't Joey Gallo, I'm picking Trevor Story. But because it's Gallo, and that dude is just a different animal when it comes to hitting home runs, he's my pick here moving on to the next round. Sorry, Trevor Story. If you went up against Olsen, Salvi, Pete Alonso even, I think I would have picked you, but going up against Gallo, that's a losing matchup. The 3 vs 6 seed, Matt Olsen versus Trey Mancini. And honestly, this one's super evenly matched. Big Matt Olsen fan, love him. But I'm gonna go with Trey Mancini here. I'm not doubting the guy. Feel good story. I wanna see Trey Mancini win, so I'm picking him. Matt Olsen has a chance to win this entire thing, just like everybody in this competition. But I think that Trey Mancini is going to be that guy. I think he's gonna have a nice line drive swing. He's gonna be able to get some home runs out of there easy. And then the last matchup of the first round, Salvador Perez going up against Pete Alonso. The Polar Bear has won the home run derby before. I think he has a really good shot to do it again. Salvador Perez, really talented hitter, of course, hits the ball very hard. One of the hardest average exit velos on batted balls in play. But I think Pete's ability, one, to take the ball to all fields and hit the home runs, as we've seen in home run derby, really helps. And two, he's done it before. He can do it again. I think Pete moves on to the second round, which gives us some really fun matchups in the second round here. You got Shohei Ohtani going up against Pete Alonso. I love Pete, but I'm not picking against Shohei Ohtani. Shohei, I think, is going going to win this one. He's just one in such incredible shape. I think he's going to be able to like last the entire round. I also don't think he's going to have to hit that many against Juan Soto, which is going to be big. You want to make sure that you're not wasting home runs early in this. You got to win by one when you're the top seed. Pete has to put up as many as he can. Shohei only has to beat Juan Soto by one. I think that's a huge advantage. I think he moves on to the finals. And then Joey Gallo going up against Trey Mancini. I hate to be chalk here, but it's going to be Joey Gallo. Like him and Ohtani are the two, I think, clear and obvious favorites for the home run derby finalists. Very well could be wrong here. I mean, it really is a crapshoot at the end of the day. But to me, Joey Gallo has too much to lose to Trey Mancini, and Shohei Ohtani has too much to lose to Pete Alonso. Both of those guys that they're going up against have to hit as many home runs as they can because they are the underdog. They are the lower seed. That is a huge disadvantage, especially in Coors, where the altitude plays a factor. Which now gives us the finals, 1-2 seed Shohei Ohtani versus Joey Gallo. And I'm going Shohei Ohtani. I'm being boring. I mean, like, how do you pick against Shohei Ohtani? Gallo's a beast. But Ohtani, just like Pete Alonso, has that ability to take the ball to left center field with ease, on a line drive, home runs, crushes baseballs, has the hardest average exit velo out of anybody in this competition, and is only slightly beat on average home run distance by Joey Gallo. We're going Ohtani here as the 2021 Home Run Derby champion, because why not? In a year where Shohei Ohtani made the All-Star team as a pitcher and a hitter and is doing Babe Ruthian things, he's doing it better than Babe Ruth. You just add the Home Run Derby to the list, and I think it makes the legend of Ohtani grow even stronger. This is going to be one of the best Home Run Derbies that we ever see. So my pick is Shohei Ohtani. I'd love to know who you guys think is going to win the Home Run Derby down in the comment section below. I'm sorry I'm boring here, but this one just feels too obvious for me. Maybe you got a different pick. Let me know in the comments down below. Make sure if you haven't yet subscribed to the channel, click the sub button. We're almost at 200K. I want to hit it today. So that would be really helpful if you could sub if you haven't done so yet. Drop a like on the video if you enjoyed it, and make sure you follow me on all my social media, GiraffeNeckMark, links in description. Thank you guys for watching. You know the drill from here on out. YouTube recommends you watch this video. This is my most recent upload. Click through those if you have not yet seen them. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you all tomorrow for another video. Bye.